That was Name for You by The Shins off of their 2017 album Heartworms. I haven't listened to The Shins that much, but I have heard a little bit of them, and that was pretty good. That was just some basic, like, kind of solid indie rock sounds. Nothing too crazy or fancy, but also nothing bad at all. It was really good. We're listening to that today because we have a song from The Magnetic Fields from 2017 up in competition today. In fact, both of our songs are from 2017. Both of our songs are from the 50-song memoir album released in 2017. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 11 of the Magnetic Fields Part 2 tournament, and that is Match 5 and Round 2. If you're new here and you're wondering what the Magnetic Fields Part 2 is, let me explain. We took every single song that the Magnetic Fields released from the year 2000 until now, 2024, and we threw them into a single elimination-style tournament. Now those songs are doing battle and head-to-head competition until we have one remaining in the end, and that's the very best song the Magnetic Fields released in that time frame. The reason we're choosing that time frame specifically is that we've already covered the first half of the Magnetic Fields discography, which was the entire 90s. So now we're following up with the latter half, just much later. If you're familiar with the Magnetic Fields, you know 50 Song Memoir is an album that's 50 songs long, just like the title would imply, but also that each song deals with a specific year in his life. And both of our songs today are separated by 30 years. First up, we've got 73, If Could Have Been Paradise. In 1973, I imagine Stephen Merritt would have been about 8. Apparently, this song has Hawaiian melodic influences that are heard throughout, and Stephen Merritt said this about that, according to Genius.com. It's in the album's lyric book. Probably my major Hawaiian music influence is actually from the Creatures album Feast, rather than from being exposed to Hawaiian music when I lived there. I didn't know he lived in Hawaii for a time. Its competition today is 03, The X and I. And that's, of course, 2003. And apparently it's about he and his ex. There aren't any notes on Genius.com on this one, so we're just going to have to listen to both of these songs. See which one's the better of the two, since that's what we usually do here. Let's go ahead and get started. Here is It Could Have Been Paradise.
We lived in Paia, hippie central. I could hop to the beach. Sometimes we would hitchhike miles to school. Being a figure of speech where we sang. We lived on a zendo in the forest, silent for days on end. Caught up on my reading, Huckleberry Finn was my only friend. It could have been Pat. Should it be paradise? That's just a place people go. It was home for a little while. But you can give me the snow. Give me the snow. My friend Shell was named for a shell on the beach. she's the pigeon English. Every day I swim out onto the reef, catching exotic fish. It could have been paradise with one good reason to stay.
Mentions another one of his songs, Shakespeare's Sister, in that in the lyrics to that. That was pretty good. I liked the weirdness of it. The percussion was really cool. I liked the chorus quite a bit, actually. And the story was, it was neat. It was kind of just like, here we are on this island paradise in Hawaii where everybody wants to be. It's so beautiful. But I ain't got nobody. I don't know why I want to be here. This place sucks. He didn't like it. He did not enjoy his time in Hawaii. I really the verse about the red bearded trumpeter that stole his song and to seduce his mother was pretty fun too. It was a good song. I like it. Let's check out the X and I. Sorry, O3, the X and I.
The ex and I, we had a one-night stand. It didn't go as planned, and things got out of hand. And the ex and I are having sex. At first it was perplexing, but now I think it's grand. So, he used to be my beau about 8 years ago, and now my tale of woe, woe, woe ends with us as more than friends. Now every evening ends with XXXXX.
So that's about getting back with his ex from like 8 years ago. So someone he broke up with when he was in his 30s, like early 30s, maybe late 20s. It was pretty good. I like the middle part especially. That part was really cool. The little weird instrumental like interlude that happened there. But other than that, I think I liked It Could Have Been Paradise a lot more. So I'm going to go with 73, It Could Have Been Paradise, for my winner today. The X and I was really fun, but It Could Have Been Paradise was even more fun. I really like that one a lot, actually. It's gonna go far on this world. Like this video if you like the video, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Share it with anyone you know who might be into this kind of content, and let me know down in the comments which of these two songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. That's all the magnetic fields action we've got going for the day, but please join me in just a little bit when we get down with our The Smiths tournament action of the day. Until then, I hope you all have a great night, fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning. Thanks for watching. Bye.